Good morning. Last Tuesday, I introduced what I thought would be a five-week-long study of the 23rd Psalm. Well, with the new guidelines from Alberta Health allowing us to reopen and have services beginning this coming Sunday, June 21st, we'll be ending our daily Devos on Trinity TV on Friday. That said, I'll be doing my best during today's Devo to wrap up Psalm 23 and what it means to me. It is an amazing piece of writing. And as I said last week, it is one of the most memorized passages of Scripture. Because we are so familiar with it, if we are not careful, we can often read it quickly and gloss over the riches it describes. For those who believe in Jesus and the good news of all he has done for us, Psalm 23 is a treasure trove of incredible riches. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. We discussed that last week, verse 1. Think about it. The Lord, the creator of the galaxies, the one who knows the name of every star and the location of every grain of sand, the one who has infinite power, the one who is sovereign over history and every detail of our lives, the Lord is my shepherd. My shepherd. If you believe in Jesus, then he is your personal shepherd. He cares about every detail of your life. He watches over you and me, and he watches out for us. He will lead and care and provide for us. Jesus will meet every genuine need his sheep have. He will provide for us. He won't leave us wanting. And because he is the Lord, he has the power to fulfill our every genuine need. I shall not want. It is not only a fact, but I often think of it as a personal decision. If I know that Jesus Christ the Lord is caring for and leading me, then I should not be complaining or whinging. As the Aussies and Brits say, we lived in Australia for 3 years, and I remember sitting in a church, and I'd never heard the term whinging before, and didn't know what the pastor was talking about. It took me a while to get the context that whinging means complaining. So, as Christians, instead of whinging, we should make every effort to practice gratitude, continually offer thanks. I know my shepherd has my best interests at heart, and will give me everything I genuinely need, so I will be content in him. Sorry about the lawnmower. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. Green pastures. Look all around me at the green. It is a picture of abundance, rest, and refreshing. A sheep lying down in a green pasture wouldn't have a care in the world. That sheep is surrounded by rich food. That sheep won't worry about whether there will be enough to eat. His good shepherd richly provides. His word is full of comforting promises and rich wisdom. His word feeds, strengthens, satisfies, and protects us. Of all the people on the earth, we who know Jesus have his word. We need to dwell in his word. Let Jesus help you lie down in it. Meditate on it. He will speak to you and give you faith, encourage, and satisfy you. He leads me beside still waters. Still waters describe peace. This same Lord who spoke to and calmed the wind and the waves on the Sea of Galilee leads his sheep into peace with God. Our shepherd also leads us into peace in this life. He tells us not to worry about what we shall eat or drink, because our Father who provides for the sparrows will surely provide for his sons and daughters. Jesus leads us into peace and helps us trust him in the midst of trials. He helps us trust him, knowing that he is in control of all things. He restores my soul. Afflictions, hardships, and challenges of everyday life can drain and exhaust us, but Jesus restores us day by day. His mercies are new every morning. We have fresh hope, new outpourings of grace. He restores us again and again. He restores our faith and gives us fresh grace. We must learn to tap into that. It's so easy to busy ourselves with other things, but we must learn every morning to seek his face. He leads me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. What a wonderful promise. Our good shepherd promises to lead us in paths of righteousness, to deliver us from sin and protect us from falling. God himself promises to personally instruct, teach, and counsel us with his eye upon us. He doesn't send an angel to tell us where we should go or what we should do. He himself does. And as Psalm 23:3 says, he leads us for his name's sake, not only for our good, but for his glory, for his name's sake. Our good shepherd leads and counsels us to walk in his ways to bring glory to the Father. The Father's glory has always been Jesus' top priority, and it is his top priority for our lives. Even in our darkest times, our shepherd promises to be with us. How great is that? Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. The valley of the shadow of death can mean when we are literally dying, or it can mean times of affliction and suffering. Yet, Jesus promises he will be with us no matter what we go through. We may not sense his nearness, but he is there, and he promises he will never leave us nor forsake us. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. I've done a little reading on shepherds, and when they lead their sheep in the darkness, if a sheep begins to stray, the shepherd hooks the sheep and brings him back with the crook of his staff. The shepherd strikes attacking wolves with his rod. Shepherds also use their rods to gently tap sheep on the side when they began to drift from the flock. Jesus continually protects us and helps us not to stray. The second half of this psalm pictures our Lord as a gracious host serving us at his table. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. We may have earthly enemies, but our greatest enemy is Satan, who desires to rob us of our joy in Christ. Our host prepares a table, and in him we have a continual feast. Jesus anoints with his spirit, and our cup overflows. In Christ we have more than we need, joy, peace, strength, and every good thing. Our host assures us of a wonderful future, both in this life and the next. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. You may think, but doesn't God's word tell us that believers will suffer afflictions of many kinds and we shouldn't be surprised when that happens? Yeah. But because our good shepherd is sovereign, infinitely wise and loving, he causes all things to work together for our good. No matter what happens to us, he pours out his mercy upon us every single day of our lives. Jesus' unceasing love for us never ceases. Every sunrise brings new miracles. His faithfulness is infinite, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. When we believe in Jesus, he gives us eternal, everlasting life in his presence. Someday, we will gaze upon his breathtaking beauty forever. He will wipe away every tear, and all we will ever know for eternity will be overflowing joy. Thank you for joining me over the last few weeks, Tuesday morning. I'm looking forward to seeing you this coming Sunday and waving at you from a distance. We'll be releasing guidelines for what to expect on our website tomorrow. Have a blessed day. May God bless you and your family.